Suddenly my cell phone was bleeping. It was that worthless fuckhead Kid Rock. Heebie, man, I got something you wanna see. I told him I'd be down soon and I found the manhole. And you better not be fucking with me. I got Wacko Jacko's head out of the trunk and took a small hit of my telepathic blend. The eyes started glowing and I got Mr. Shit on the brain line, told him I was heading into a meeting with a non-scuzz bag and I might need backup Rock, and his posse of burned out rigger stag moved into Tree's old tent, making it their acid trip crash pad. I knew my cruel punk ass crackheads would only get me killed down there. Shit said they'd be down as soon as possible, and asked me for details on the situation. I started to tell him to expect an ambush, but the King of Pot started electrocuting me again and I had to cut the call short. 6 minutes later I was back down in the sewer. What the fuck you want, you cheap jack funk? I asked, keeping my Glock at the ready. Kid had a small cardboard box between his boots and he lifted it and held it up to the light. Inside, in a nest of shredded newspapers, was some kind of hideous head of Tom Cruise trailing 20 sticky pieces of ectoplasmic gunk for its lobes and body. I writhed as the thing in the box twitched, giving me the evil eye. Holy Jesus, fuck! I gasped. A piece of duct tape was pasted across its mouth. Fucking thing wouldn't quit singing, hound dog, Rock said with a shudder. I mean, I love the King as much as anybody, but Christ, shut up, I snapped. Where did you get this? Hey? Man, don't be a prick. I seized Kid Rock by the collar and stuffed the Glock spiral deep into his scrawny tattooed neck. You listen to me, you little slimy chicken shit scum sucker. This whole shit house is coming down on our heads if we don't strike soon, very soon. Now tell me where you got this. I bellowed. Rock's pupils looked the size of dimes. I slammed my fist into his scrotal sack for good measure. Rock just let out a pathetic cough and whimpered, drooling in a heap on the cement. One of his thugs, a 7'8" with a shaven scalp, stepped forward, drawing a billy club. Take one more goddamn step, fat boy, and they'll be peeling your ass skin off the ceiling with a razor blade for 12 weeks. He stopped, frowned. That's good. I kicked Kid in his guts one more time and screamed, where did you get it? Rock, blubbered, vomiting blood, my glue-loo-twig. My girlfriend, she-she-shloo-twig. She said, ruling said it all. I stopped kicking his ribcage and internal organs for a second and got on my knees. Where is she? I bellowed. Tell me. I'm right here, a metallic Helvich voice spoke from behind me. I spun around, but it was too late. A sharp nailed hand whipped out, slashing my face and sending me flying with the force of a horse kick. My head hit the concrete wall and I saw purple-orange lights. I caught brief flashes of a black insectile she-demon with a foot-long with flashing green forked tongue. The hell cunt was on me, thrashing me against the walls and floor with enough force to shatter the ancient cement and send me to the edges of consciousness. I had my trusty Enfield still in its shoulder holster. If I could just reach it, all of a sudden the room fills with noise like a jet exploding and 10 million flashbulbs blind me. Ed McMahon's head appears for a moment amid blasts of sulfuric smoke, and now Hank, Chip and Norman appear standing there, the crazy bikers holding M16s. Mr. Shit's voice echoes through the subatomic ether. What the F-U-U-U-U-C-K? In his backwards drawl. I got you, Vince. Hank shouts. He shoot the hell bitch through her third red eye and she makes a sound like 10,000 cockroaches dying in bubbling tar. Norman helps me up. You okay, dude? My head is all smashed and on the right side. I can't find my balance, but otherwise I'm ready for my next hit of space crack and a Jack Daniels. I show Hank what's inside the cardboard box and he says, now we've got a fighting chance. I'm not sure what he's got planned, but he might be right, it just might be our last chance. I hear Kid Rock whimpering and now I see him in a heap, sobbing, clutching his demon bitch lover's rapidly disintegrating ectoplasmic corpse. Hank's about to put him out of his misery when a dying Hasselhoff fetus queefs out the demon's match and devours Kid Rock's head in a single peristaltic succubus chomp with 6 rows of teeth. We all pull iron and blast it away before it can break into its inevitable creepy rendition of Hound Dog, or The Ghetto.